It's now a great pleasure to introduce our speaker, Dr. Javier Nieto, who has served as Dean of the College of Public Health and Human Sciences since fall of 2016. He is a leading epidemiologist and population health specialist with more than 25 years of experience in teaching and research. So please welcome Dean Javier Nieto.
You recognize this, I'm sure. When you go to the doctor, they give you this form, two-sided, with all sorts of questions about your health and whether you had mumps, whether you have hearing loss. How many questions about sleep in this form? Exactly 0.00. Not one single question about sleep. I actually gave my doctor a hard time about that. But the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC, has declared insufficient sleep a public health epidemic because of, again, the consequences of sleep deprivation that I'm going to discuss to present today, but also because there's very troubling trends in the population. The percent of people who sleep less than 6 hours is increasing over time in both genders and in across all age groups, including children, older people, etc., etc. People are sleeping less and less and less. Take home messages. Breathing is good for you. I'm going to show you something that is shocking to me. This is the world-class experts in hypertension management and control in the United States, and in JAMA, one of the leading journals in medicine. Another quiz. How many times sleep is mentioned in this report? 0.00. Not one single word. The American Heart Association report on recommendations for management and prevention of heart disease. Number of times is mentioned sleep in this report? 0.00. Not one single word. I mean, it's absolutely shocking. Okay, this is state by state, the prevalence of obesity. This is BMI of more, body mass index of more than 30. 10 to 14% in the darker blue, and less than 10% in the lower, in the lighter blue. Oregon was in the upper range at that time. 5 years later, they have to add a new color because now there are some states that have more than 15%. 10 years later, they have three new colors. And 2010, there is no one single state in the country at this point. Now things are getting worse. This actually, this is a report from Harvard School of Public Health that was just published a week ago, projecting that the prevalence of obesity will be 50% in this country in 10 years. This is scary. Insomnia and risk of depression. Prior insomnia was associated with an onset of depression, a risk of almost fourfold, comparing those with insomnia to those without insomnia. Insomnia is associated with significant changes in your brain structure that predict your risk of Alzheimer's disease. This is, of course, very troubling. We sleep to forget some of the things we learn each day. It's like cleaning up what happened in your brain during the day so that your hard drive doesn't get full and you can continue to function. The American Academy of Pediatrics recommends delaying start times of middle and high school to combat teen sleep deprivation. To have kids in middle school, in junior high, going to school, as my kids did, at 7:30 a.m. is absolutely insane. It's a travesty. Yeah. It's very convenient to drop off your kid at 7 a.m. or at 8 a.m. and then go to work. It's very convenient for us or for our employers. But it's devastating for kids. Learning and health. Making sure the sleep environment is pleasant, the lighting, the temperature, that is not too warm, that is 60 to 67 degrees in your bedroom is the right temperature. Generally, soft light at night, that's incredibly important. Not expose yourself to, for example, going to bed with your tablet, that's a really bad idea. Before electric light was discovered, we only have candles. So, and we didn't have TV or Instagram. So what did we do when it was dark? We went to sleep. We read and then fall asleep. So we were entirely dependent on light as a regulator of our circadian life and our physiology. We are changing very rapidly in a way that is completely upsetting our circadian rhythms and then the hormonal cycles that are very tightly regulated, and that we still don't know very well what the consequences of those are. So things are changing. Medical schools now are training doctors on sleep disorders and the impact of for health. So future generations of doctors will be better positioned for that. So I would expect professionals that are required to go through continuing education are catching up on these issues.